This video gives you 8 tips for how to get the most from a kilowatt electricity usage monitor. A kilowatt electricity usage monitor is a great tool for helping you to identify ways to reduce electricity use around your home. It allows you to plug in electrical appliances, and it then shows you how much electricity the appliance consumes and how much it's costing you. As we said in our March 2011 newsletter on smart home devices, what gets measured gets managed, and knowing what your appliances are actually consuming can help you to save money by eliminating wasted energy and making the most energy-efficient use of the appliances in your home. So let's look at 8 tips that we have come up with for helping you to get the most from a kilowatt device. Borrow one from your local library. Rather than purchasing a kilowatt device, which costs about $25, many public libraries now offer the free use of a kilowatt monitor that you can check out and then return when you are finished. After using it, you may decide that you want to buy one to have around your home. But if you have learned enough about your appliances from the kilowatt that you borrowed from the library, then this can save you the cost of the kilowatt device. Use an extension cord or power strip. Many people complain that when they plug their kilowatt into a wall socket and then plug an appliance into the device, that they have to crawl on their hands and knees to read the device. A great way to avoid this problem is to first plug your kilowatt into a grounded extension cord or power strip so that you can then plug the extension cord into the wall and have the kilowatt where you can more easily see it. Use the forecast feature. The kilowatt is designed to record how much electricity an appliance uses over a period of time, but you can also use it to get a snapshot forecast of how much electricity the appliance is expected to use over an hour, a day, a month, or even a year. To use this forecast feature, just plug an appliance into the kilowatt, hold the reset button to clear it, and then push the menu button until you see costs displayed. Then you can push the up and down buttons to view the forecast cost for an hour, day, month, or year. Keep in mind, however, that this snapshot forecast will not be accurate for an appliance that cycles on and off, such as the refrigerator. Check your TV and DVR. One of the first things that you will want to check with your kilowatt device is your television, cable box, and digital video recorder if you have one. As we mentioned in our August 2010 newsletter on vampire power, your TV, cable box, and DVR can continue to suck a lot of electricity even when they are turned off. After you check these appliances with your kilowatt and see how much their vampire power use actually costs you, it will likely convince you to purchase a separate power strip that you can use to turn them off completely. As mentioned in our article, you may even want to purchase a wireless or programmable outlet, which can make this more convenient. Check your computer and peripherals. Another good place to check with your kilowatt device is your computer and its associated devices, such as printers, speakers, wireless networks, and external hard drives. Like your TV and DVR box, seeing how much vampire power these suck when they are turned off will likely convince you to start using a power strip to turn all of these off when they are not in use. And if you have a fax machine in your home, then when you see how much vampire power it sucks when it's just sitting there waiting for the occasional fax, it will likely convince you to get rid of your fax machine altogether and instead use an online fax service. Check your lamps. An interesting thing to do with your kilowatt device, if you have a regular incandescent light bulb in one of your lamps, is to plug it into your kilowatt device and then replace the bulb with a more energy-efficient compact fluorescent bulb. When you see how much less electricity the compact fluorescent bulb uses, it will likely convince you to start replacing all of the incandescent bulbs in your home with CFLs. Check your extra refrigerator. If you have an extra refrigerator in your garage or basement, then use your kilowatt device to check its power use. Since a refrigerator cycles on and off, you should leave it plugged into your device for several days to get a good indication of its actual power consumption. When you see how much this extra refrigerator costs you to use, you may decide it's time to donate it to a worthy charity, rather than having it running all the time at your house and only being occasionally used. Check your phone chargers. Lastly, use your kilowatt to check your cell phone chargers to see how much vampire power they suck when they are plugged into the wall without being connected to your phone. You may have seen articles in the news about how much electricity phone chargers use when they're not being used. Well, by using a kilowatt device, you can tell if your phone charger really is one of the culprits. In many cases, you may find that your charger only draws a few cents a year in electricity, and it's not worth the effort of remembering to unplug it or investing in a separate power strip for it. A kilowatt electricity usage monitor is a great tool for finding ways to reduce electricity use around your home. We hope this video has given you helpful tips for how to get the most out of this smart home device. This video is powered by HomeWizard.com, personalized reminder software used by home service providers who really care about their customer.